World Suicide Prevention Day, and as we're all too painfully aware, it's an issue that we in New Zealand urgently need to take action on. But what kind of action? The government allocated more than $1 billion to mental health in this year's budget and announced the first use of some of those funds on Sunday, and is expected to finally unveil a long-awaited suicide prevention plan later today. Meanwhile, the Key to Life Charitable Trust is launching a new project to help us understand and ultimately overcome what causes Kiwis to take their own lives. Here to explain what it involves and how you might be able to help is Trust founder and ambassador and New Zealander of the Year, of course, Mike King.
Stop it.
Oh, you've got to milk
I'm
it.
I'm a Kiwi, we hate it. Don't.
I know, but I think, you know, part of feeling good about ourselves is accepting.
Yes, and that's part of the problem with Kiwis. We don't want to take compliments, we refuse to take compliments, and what we're role modelling to our kids is we can't be successful. So what I should have said when you said that is thank you, Hayley.
Thank you.
I'm very proud, thank you.
You're welcome, and you deserve it.
Thank you.
Yes. So let's talk about this suicide prevention plan to be unveiled today. What would you like to see in it?
Look, there's I'm not going to usurp the Prime Minister by announcing what I would like to see in it here. Look, I've seen it. It's not going to please everybody, but it's a good plan.
Does it please you?
Yes, it did. It did. Finally, they're acknowledging that suicide is not a mental illness. It's a case of trauma. There's all kinds of different things involved, self-esteem. So they're acknowledging that. I mean, at the moment, if you go to the doctor and say, look, I'm having these thoughts, you're automatically classified mentally ill. Having a suicidal thought does not make you mentally ill. It makes you human.
It makes you a normal person.
That's right.
Actually,
everyone's walked out of the door and go, what's the point?
Yeah.
Oh, the point is, if I do that, then I'll miss out on this party and I'll miss out on catching up with my kids and all of that sort of thing. So look, it's not going to please everybody, but it's just time that we united as a country, everyone, all these agencies, all of these people who are competing for funding, time to put down your swords and let's get in behind this and let's get in and support it. I think it's a great start, and this government has a proven track record of starting things like and announcing that there is more to come. So, yeah, it's just time we got on with it.
And they're like a long-term plan, which is surprising and great as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
So you are going to try and contribute to the well-being of New Zealand yourself. You're trying to get to the heart of what is causing Kiwis to take their own lives. You're launching 1,000 letters. Can you tell us about that?
So 1,000 letters. Over the years that I've been on the road talking to people up and down the country, I've been blessed by having families share their final words, share the final words of their loved ones who have taken their own lives. And although each one of these stories is horrific and tragic, I've noticed that there are three common trends in each one of these letters. And so we'd like to give some researchers an insight, have a look at these, deep dive into those things and see if there are any common factors that we should all be aware of so we can prevent other suicides in the future.
What an insight that you must have got, a tragic, moving insight.
It is. And it really annoys me that every time I see our experts on TV, the response when they're asked about why someone's taking their lives, their answer's always the same. Well, it's a very complex issue and there are so many different reasons. Look, the common themes that I've noticed in all of these letters, there are three common themes and they all involve hurt. Number one, people want to take their life. Number one, I'm hurting and I need the pain to stop. Every day people tell me that I'll get over this, but every day it's worse and I can't do it anymore, it needed to stop. So one, I'm hurting. Two, I'm causing hurt. I feel like I've become a burden to everybody and everybody will be better off without me. And number three, in a small number of cases, I want to cause hurt. You hurt me, now I'm going to hurt you. So from what I'm seeing in my unacademic and unclinical brain is, at the heart of all suicide, people aren't drama queens, attention seekers, cowards, all of these words that we use, they're just people who are hurting.
And helpless.
And if we could be aware that they're hurting and do everything in our power to get them to that better place, the whole world would be better off. And this is information that all Kiwis need to know.
I think that whole idea of being aware that someone's hurting, we're so busy at the moment.
Yep.
Everyone's always in a bad mood, so how are you going to know if how deep that pain is? Well, how do we talk to each other?
Well, we ask people all the time, how are you? You've left home feeling crap.
But you say, fine, thanks.
Yeah, you've left home feeling crap.
And
how are you? I'm fine. I want to peel your face off with a fork, but I'm fine, right? You have that horrible feeling. People don't know how to talk. So the inner critic is the biggest problem in mental health right now, that little voice that constantly tells you, especially if you've got rejection issues and self-esteem issues like me, that little voice that can't take a compliment, that little voice that's constantly telling you you're not good enough.
That big voice in New Zealand that's telling people that showing your feelings is weakness.
Yeah. So the easiest way I find now when people ask me the question, how are you today, and it's an answer that's, you know, doesn't make you go, oh, I didn't want to take that. How are you today? My inner critic is smashing me today, which is just a signal that, you know, please don't put any crap on me today. Please don't make jokes today. I'm struggling today, but in a way that you can get your head around and go, good. And then you can alert other people around the office, hey, Hayley's having a bit of a bad day today. Let's all get them behind.
And make sure you respect that when someone tells you that.
That's lovely, isn't it? So we're hoping that we're hoping to get 1,000 letters from New Zealanders, which will give us a really valuable insight. This is the first time this has been done in New Zealand, and any families out there who send their letters to us, 1000letters.co.nz, we will treasure these. Your privacy will be, obviously privacy will be respected. And we just want a chance for families to honour the loved ones that you've lost, and maybe prevent this from happening again. So 1000 letters, you know, this .co.nz, this is what we want to do to help other New Zealanders.
Thank you so much, Mark King, for coming in. We really appreciate it, and talking about probably one of the most important issues we have. And if you or anyone you know needs help or needs someone to talk to, there are people and services available, so please use the numbers that you see on your screen now. And honestly, asking for help is not a weakness, it is a strength.
I couldn't agree more.
Yes.